used as part of the series of checks which should be completed to help demonstrate that LEV is controlling mist exposure. The methods in this video should be used during commissioning of LEV systems and at the thorough examination and test. They can also be used as part of regular checks to ensure the LEV is effective. They may be carried out by the LEV supplier, thorough examiner or in-house. It's important that your supplier demonstrates to you through commissioning that the LEV works as intended, so you know it's protecting your workers. Your supplier should have discussed with you the volume of air that needs to be extracted and how quickly this needs to happen, as this will affect the time delay before the machine doors can be opened. Account should also have been made for different machining programs. The LEV should be tested, and if fitted with an airflow indicator, the readings checked to make sure it's working properly. Use a dust lamp, and optionally a DRAM as well, to check that no mist is leaking from the enclosure and LEV filter, either through the filter itself or from the seals or housing. Both pieces of equipment should be set up and used as described earlier. To do this with a dust lamp, look for particles around the LEV filter unit during machining. For DRAM, hold it near to where air is extracted through the filter, but also around seals in the casing of the LEV unit. A smoke generator can be used to establish the time delay required between the machine stopping and opening the enclosure doors. This should be long enough for the LEV to extract the mist, so when the operator opens the doors, no mist is present in their breathing zone, which is the space within 20 to 30 centimetres of their nose and mouth. For many machines, this will be the same as the clearance time, which is the time it takes for the entire enclosure to be cleared of smoke. However, in some cases, particularly larger enclosures, the operator's breathing zone may be clear before the enclosure is cleared entirely. Prepare the smoke generator for use according to the manufacturer's instructions. You should also check that smoke can be used in the building and won't set off any fire alarms. Otherwise, arrange to have them temporarily turned off. Ensure the enclosure windows are clean, so you'll be able to see smoke inside and the LEV is switched off. Fill the enclosure with smoke until you can no longer see the other side of the enclosure, opposite the door. Close the door, turn on the LEV and start a stopwatch. Record the time it takes for smoke to be sufficiently cleared by the LEV such that no mist is present in the operator's breathing zone on opening of the doors. Then repeat the test. This time can be used to program the delay before the interlocks allow the doors to be opened. Where this is not possible, a timer should be used. You should also walk around the machine to look for any smoke escaping and make a note of any areas. This may be an indication the LEV is not working correctly or the design is not suitable. As well as being carried out with the commissioning of the LEV system, it's recommended that this is repeated during the statutory thorough examination and test every 14 months. This will provide an opportunity to review the time delay and account for any changes in machining processes or procedures. The time delay can also be established using a dust lamp to visualise clearance of actual mist generated by machining. Ensure the level of lighting inside the enclosure provides sufficient contrast to view the mist. This could be by turning the machine lighting off or covering it up. Use a smoke pen or tube around openings while the process is running to check the LEV draws air in rather than letting mist escape. Activate the chemical that generates the white smoke according to the manufacturer's instructions. Ensure that the LEV is switched on. Puff smoke near to any openings of the enclosure, for example the door seals or part chutes. The smoke should be clearly drawn into the enclosure. Use a dust lamp and optionally a DRAM as well to check for leaks from seals, chutes and other openings during machining. If you undertook smoke testing to determine the clearance time, then you may already have identified any leaks. If, however, you did not use smoke, you should check for any leaks associated with the machine enclosure by walking around to identify common areas such as door seals and the rear and top of the machine. Some may be more obvious than others. The checks are important to ensure the LEV is working effectively and protecting your workers.